You guys got your CNC books? He's got his, I know.
I'm pretty sure I have.
You're gonna need the cheat sheets in there.
This one's got CNC book. Little thin, just like a little cheap paper.
Oh, that was inside my binder in the box over there.
Where is that? I can remember the formulas, but I didn't cheat sheet for the how fast it beat it. So.
That's not the main program. That's not the main program.
Yep. Just the main program. Thousands. I'll wait close for a quarter. Because it's part of it, too. So, the first thing we have to do with our program is we always put a percent sign at the top. This is in your computer, so you don't want to type it all. But I have a funny feeling that mistakes and besties, that's how best makes the roll. Mitchell, are you that way?
There is a percent. There is a percent.
There is a percent sign. So, the next thing we need is a letter O. Capitalized with four or five numbers behind it. So, let's do it. That's what you do. This is the amazing 13th. And this is 2023. It's the number 1323. You guys are ready. So behind that, Justin's got a description of 1.5 dovetail. Yada yada yada. You guys have the rest, right? Now we have to decide where the easiest place to put our X and our Y are. So we can pretty much put X and Y wherever we want. But I'll tell you guys, it's easier to write a CNC program with all your numbers are pretty much the same. Which is why probably 99% of the time when writing a program, you're going to put it right in the middle right there. So X0, Y0 is the middle.
two.
Is R times L. You guys should already know why I put it in this.
Because it's nice.
Yeah, it's in parentheses like that, either. The controller over here. And then after that, he has suspects for the rapture.
Dave, if you don't put them in parentheses, does it throw an error on the
Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we'll run. It'll say undefined code or something like that. So, below that, he's got the rapture style. So now, the next thing we say is C is in 6. Remember what that is? Right, so if I do an if 6 followed by a T4,
that's a tool chain.
Yeah. You know what it means? Yeah. It's a T4, right? Yep. So now we have our, basically it's preparatory line or insulation line. Some of this kitchen stuff, some of the terms of song, certain things. So now you have a line that says G0, G20, G40, G80 and G90. I was told I needed to start doing this to my engineers so they didn't know what that is. So now we have T4 was our three-inch shelving, which has got carbide inserts in it. And how many fluids is it? Let's figure it out 5. Super right. You've got to go about it. So take your book, and it'll say, it's a high word carbide. So if you look, it's carbide. So what's our surface speed in our book for carbide? Times 4 divided by
66, 67, 66.
That's what we usually do. And actually, RPM, you don't have to have that. That'll make the total gap. Everything else pretty much has to happen. So now we take our RPM, if you look on that one page with the formula, we multiply by chip load and by the number of loops. And that gives us our heat rate.
So if the surface speed per minute times 4, or the surface so take your RPM times your chip load times the number of
loads. Yeah, so if you flip back to the other page, it'll show you chip load over here. So aluminum, and then size matters. So we're greater than an inch, so it's going to be 7,000. Times 5. Let's take this for a heat rate. And we're not doing 6,000 with a summer enrollment. We're going to do it as of 66. Now we're going to do G55. So our controller, the one process that you guys are usually using, we do G54 to G59. And I always suggest when I take programming class that you do one step in one offset, one step in like the next offset, one setup. So every setup you change your offsets. That way you less have to keep them confused with each other. Plus if you mess up, you've already got part of the offsets if you have to start over. So G55. Justin has an X of minus 3 and a Y of 0. So an X of minus 3, so which way is minus? Or which way is negative?
So the X of negative 3. Going to the right.
So here's my part,
and I'll show you how you got to the 3. I'll go back on it. Firstly, I go 10 because that's going to be so close. So here's your part. Actually, that might be wrong. Because what is that? That's 2 inches, right? Oh, he's not. So this distance here is 2 inches, correct? So what is the distance from here to here? Going this way. So what's that distance right there? That's about starting in the center. Yeah. So if I start in the center, what's the distance this way?
7-1.
1.
Yeah, that's an inch.
Because you've got 2 up here, so you just divide by 2. So now he said 3, so he's got another 2 inches off the side. So the center of the end mill was setting over here. And so, consider the facing. Yeah, it's set over here. So technically, if you're 3 inches from the center of here to the center of here, and you've got to take off an inch and a half of this. You want to make sure you don't start it apart. So the radius is 1.5. So you've got a 1 inch part and you're still a half inch away. Does that make sense? You follow me? Nobody completely ever understands this the first time. Usually. So, here's what I'm trying to do. So we know this is an inch from here to here. I wanted to make sure my end mill starts off. So if I do my part plus the radius of my cutter, you're going to get 2.5. And I'm off 3 inches. So there should be like a half an inch gap right here. So we can go with this. That's cool.
Well, why do you want that to happen?
I just don't want to start off the farm. It could be 100,000. And this doesn't matter. I just prefer it.
Well, you want it to be able to come over and
yeah, down into it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Down into it. That's
it. I can imagine that best one.
It's just, there's other surface that we should do. So, G43, that's our height offset of our tool. Since you guys don't know, because there's an H4 right behind it, and H refers to the height of that tool. So this tells the computer G43, and my height offset is H4, and it goes and finds the width of that tool. And then we've got a Z of 0.1. So, this move right here and this move right here activate your offsets, and then it travels to those two spots. Both that have.
So now we've got a G01, a feed rate of 50, and a C of -0.050. The reason we do this and do a feed rate would really go to the one.
We did go there to zero. But we tried to do time and 0.17, so oh crap, I'm wrong. So that just slows it down. So instead of it going, come on, it's going to come down.
Well, it hasn't come over yet, but yeah. This is just down.
That's a Z.
That's a Z. So you're going down 50,000. So you're going to take 50,000 right off top. And then after that, you put an X, that's 3. So there's your move to go across. And we said our feed rate was supposed to be what?
1066.
No, feed rate. 37.3. And now we've gone all the way across the part. We're setting half inch off the part over here. So now we're just going to go home. G00. We're going to same distance by the park first, so 100,000 foot where our sock was, G28, G91, G0. That takes us through all the way up home. And then G90, M1, and time to go to the next one. This part might be a little confusing. M6, what do I want next? Three, same. Why do we get ready to run something? 220, 80, 290.
Are those just the general codes and the voice up put in?
Yeah, this is a cancel code for cutter comp. This is a cancel code for any drilling cycles. This is just G0 is a rapid move. G90. Put you in a certain mode, and well, honestly, you don't want that one. But yeah, you just use them every time like a robot.
Why do you have to?
Because you have to have the machine set up to where you want it. You never touch what was done before. It's just a little safety thing. I mean, if you're right, this code to the shop, you may or may not do it this way. The first time, you're going to have to, because it could refer back to the last program thing. After that,
even though you have your current program loaded, even though you have your current program
loaded. But there are certain modes that will stay in until you kick it out. So it'll stay in like a G41 until you put it in a G40. It'll stay in a G83 until you put it in a G80. That's what that one's for, and that's what that one's for.
And the G41 is just different. Like we were talking, cut on one side of the line, or the G42. The GA3 is just a drilling cycle. So you have to have that original code to kick it out of that mode.
You're just basically making sure it's what you want.
Yeah.
You're supposed to cancel all those when you're done with them, but supposed to actually do is a whole other.
I mean, is that something we should get in the habit of writing programs?
Like that, yeah. That's how we run it. We run 17. So I didn't look at this program on the line, so I don't know where to go. So he's got G55, which keep your same work offset all the way through that one program. You can change between programs, but don't change the middle of the program. He's got X of -1.0, Y of -1.5. So if that's true, where is he?
He's kind of like
here at the lake.
Yeah. The lake. looks like you're right.
So think what cutter we have first. What size is it?
We're going to, you know, it looks like you're going to step that, that slide between the two.
My zero zero is right here. So we have got right through this one and right through this one. So X is negative or positive over here. It's positive.
These are my fingers.
So that way it's positive. That
way it's positive.
Up is positive. So technically, if you're looking at the part on the table, X is negative over here. X is negative up here. X is positive over here. X is positive over here. Now, negative Y, Y over here, Y, Y, and Y. Make sense? So now if we've got two negatives, what are you at to start with? Yeah. So now we have negative 1 and y is negative 1.5. So you're at negative 1.5 y is over here. You need negative 1 x from there, so you don't need this.
So you're
actually, just because it looks like cut. So, what he's going to do is he's going to start here, and your cutter comp always has to be turned on with something here. So he's going to go over here like this, and then he's going to go up like this, follow that line, come off like this, and then you have to turn it off with a linear loop also. I think that is what's going inside. Does that make sense? Yeah. Somebody's actually over there. And it's going to come over here. And it's going to this side. And it's going to come off like this. Because you want to keep the cutter inside of the 90 degree loop. So instead of going up here and down the long way, you want to force it to go from the center here to the cutter being right on the edge of the line here, and then it will turn and go up, and it'll come back out. As it comes back out, we'll put a G40 here, which returns it to the middle. So down here you go to the G41, and that's going to put it to the left side of the line as you're following it. So if I'm the little person standing back here looking, behind it at this angle, is it left or right? Does that make sense? That's a line.
It's a right on the line.
Now if you're standing here, pretend like it's in front of you. Put your pencil up like that. Is it on the left side of your pencil or the right side of your pencil?
It's on that way, it's on the right side.
My line. Okay.
So that's G41, this is the left side of the line.
Right? Yeah. Oh, I thought you said that. Yeah, it's on the left side. So
well, I mean,
we almost never use G42s.
Well, I mean, from that perspective, it looks like you're cutting on the right side of the line.
Well, but I'm standing here looking at it. So if it was a little tornado and this is the street I live on and my house is on this side, I want it on that side, right? It doesn't make sense. So go check your house out. A little more away. Times 4 divided by what? That's going to be really, really fast.
3 is
8, 16, 32, 32 times 64 is going to be 64, and that's like 12,000 something.
More than eight. Okay, go that fast.
12,000 is the max.
Huh?
12,000 is the max, or is it 9,000?
9, depending on which is. The auger seems a little different.
The BF. What is the
BF? The BF3 is, I think it's 9, but 750 is
not a little bit moving.
So we're just going to go 9,000. That's why we're doing that. And now they give you the opportunity to show you what you do with it. When you set your speed at that, so I set my speed at a certain number because I can't go that fast, and I calculate my speed up off that. So now we've got G43. My H is going to be what number? G43 is my height cost, so
30.
My H is 3.
It is 2.
Yep. Z, 0.1, so I'm going someplace safe above the park and make turn my cooler off. Now I'm going to go G01, Z of negative 0.174. Rate is 50. Suppose it's the P rate. What should the P rate be? Probably do this too, because your next semester is all about this. This is Justin's trying not to scare the daylights out of everybody, but not letting you know what you can do into next semester.
Is he going to be 0.007 again since it's in?
Oh, he doesn't say. We're going to say that's 2, yeah. So what he did is he did the 9,000 up here times the, what did you write? What, 2,000?
Yeah.
Times,
that's because it's the 900 was 100.
Yeah.
And he took the 2,000.
36. That's better than 50. That's better than 50. So where I say, oh, that's a Z, never mind. So he drops in Z, we're all getting ready to do our thing. And if you notice on our print, on our print, our dimension says it's supposed to be 100. Oh, I know why. So, we took how much off the top?
That's 0.1. Nope.
We took 50,000 off the top. That's our show number, right?
Yeah.
And now our print says we're supposed to be 124,000 deeper, so this is how we got there.
$50,000
for the show and 124 for the print. So that's how he gets to 1. See how I assume these were all inside the printer.
We only have it left in the
Now we've got T01, which is a linear move. Oh, yeah. So G01, G41, that's by Peter Kopplak. G03. So now the order is back to tool 3. Everything for that tool 3 is 3. And then he's got an X of 0, pins, 1, 3, 4. And how we can figure that out is we need, if our 0, 0 is in the middle, you're going to have half of this on each side. So we can take that by, you divide by 2, what do you get? That's 0.265 divided by 2. You're going to get 15.5. Right? Isn't that divided by 2? 265 divided by 2, remember that? So 0.265 divided by 2. 0.264 divided by 2. Straight up this line. And we say that line is at x of positive 0.325. And this is going to turn, when we move from here to there, it'll turn the Peterkopf on too. The rule with Peterkopf is you have to move at least the radius of the cutter. Bare minimum. Now we're going to do a y of 0.5.
What do you think it was? 1.34. What do you think it was? 1.34 and not 1.34.
I would just go off of that.
Why do you think you put that in? Rather than the 265 divided by 265 divided by 286.
Make a mistake, you will forget five.
So if you would go in 1.34, and that would
be 2. Because if it's at 1.34, you're going to take off an extra. We're at 1.325. What we're taking off is at 1.34. Give me a look. I mean, that's only a sphere call. It's designed to sit at one. So you'd end up, by the time you're over, you're going to be a thou and a half here. You're going to be about 3 thou big. You're going to take a thou and a half too much off each side. He might have done it for a little bit of slop. We're going to see if we can make this just go. Let's
So y of 1.5, so that would be up here, correct?
Yeah.
Because we went over, now we come over. And now technically we can stay in the same code and we can either come over like this and then just come back down, which is what he's getting ready to do. So if you notice, I only put on my line what changes. Up here we had our z set, and then I changed my x, keeping the theme over here, so it's only got an x, we don't have a y. And then the next line we have a y and no x. So now we're just going to do an x of, we put 1 point something.
So you wouldn't have to necessarily turn the cutter pump off in that.
But then he never wrote the last one. I think he said here, I'm turning it off and now to you guys to figure out the 30-second out. Because he doesn't have the other side on here. But you can't cut a 265,000 watt clock with a 250,000 watt meter. So you've got to come back down the other side. So if it was me, I would come out of the hole, come over, come straight back down, and then walk over and turn the cutter cap off, which is what we're going to do.
Well, he's got another, like, you know, G00, Z0.1, X0.1.
Oh. Yeah, but it says dovetail, he's changed the tools.
I've got another group of lines.
Different tool number.
No, same tool number. Because he comes back G01, G41, D03, and then another.
Okay, I totally misaligned.
Another 13, 134, but I changed it to 13.5.
I think I accidentally skipped a line. Follow along with me.
I mean, but is it
y of 1.5, x of negative,
and then g4.
So this is 0 for 0, g4, 0, x of negative, 0, 4, 1, 2, and a half, and 2, and a half. I was just going to keep going. Because left is left. Because we're going up on the left, we're going to go over, and now we'll come back down and stay on the left. You don't actually have to turn it off. So, we're going to take his, and we're going to do to his what I want you guys to do in mind when you're in my 117 class. You can modify it to make it work for you, but we want to stay within these boundaries, because if you guys don't stay within these boundaries, you're impossible to help.
Yeah.
I may spend 30 minutes looking for a problem instead of two. Remember when Jake kind of went out a little off the rails and had himself funky?
Yep. So after y 1.5 and x negative 1.
Well, this x is not negative. If you're going to go to what we're going to do, the x is not negative 1. It's negative something, but it's not negative 1. And so where was our line at before? On the other side, we said it was supposed to be x of 1.325, right?
Yes.
So now we just want a negative. This is why you put 0, 0 in the middle. So now we want a negative 0.1325. Because now we're going to stay on this side of the line and we're going to straight back down over here.
This is the line right after y 1.5.
We're going to do this little trick right here. And I was taught by Justin, we also don't all write the same thing that way. That's how we can tell what's in the sheets.
Yeah.
If your code matches word for word, we got one. So it fell out right next to it. So
point comes over, we've got up our little blue line, we come off the top. So now I want to come back to and cut this line. So I want to go over it that much. So that's going to be my negative whatever, right? Negative 1.325x. So x is negative 1.325. Now after I get here, I want to come straight down like this and off the part. So you can pick any x you want, or y you want that's off the part. You did 1.5 on the top, right?
Yeah,
so we can do a y of negative 1.5 down here. And then we have to turn our cutter comp off, but we want to turn inside it. Basically, it's like playing horseshoes. You keep it in the horseshoe, and you got to come off at least half of the radius of the cutter. We got a quarter inch anymore. I'm not going to make that hard, so to find that negative 1.325, and I say, let's say x of 1.2, this piece. I see the number. So I'm coming off 2.325. Who cares? That's more than no. But it's something easy to figure out. Okay. So at this point, we had x of negative 1.325, so we're here. And I want to go here, so what's going to change? Get that. Y by y. So I want y of negative 1.5. And then now it's going to change. X wants to be 1.0, and then that's where I need my 240 line. Make sense? So now that I've done, I'm going to go G00. You have 0.1, same below my part, G28, G91, G of 0, G90, and 1. What's it like? Option stop? Yeah, so that means if your option stop, but it's first, it's going to stop it, so we'll change. Which is a nice option to have if you need it.
So if the M1 code is already in there, I don't think I saw it on any of the codes.
That's the way it's written. Yeah, it's right here. So it's very easy to use for.
So you wouldn't necessarily have to push the optional stop.
No, if that code's not there and you have the optional stop button pushed, you just bring that past. That gives you the option of optional stop. You don't put that in there, you can see the optional stop all the way on. Because it's looking for it.
So I have no
option. So now, one tool left, right?
Yeah.
M6T what?
Two.
And if you guys notice his little notes over here, I usually write mine the same way because by the time you get to this program, you're like, what tool is that? Did I use the right one? At least this one pulls it out, you know, if it doesn't pull out the right one, or not. Now we're going to go with the cancel prep code, so G0, G20, 240, 280, 290. And people are saying 255. Now he's got x of negative 1.75 and y of negative 1.5, which is going to put you there. Pretend like you're in grade school doing geometry, finding points.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. Remember when we used to graph all those points in grade school and you go, oh, I'm going to use this graph.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. Guess what? We could use it.
Yeah.
Often. So we're both negative, right?
Yeah.
So that means we're going to be like
more quantum.
So now, at this point, the only thing I care about, because we know our email, if we cut the angle on here, so the only thing I care about is from here to here and from there to there, all the way around. So we've got an inch and a half by an inch and a half square, because we can ignore the slot in the middle. It means nothing to us. We want to dovetail on both of these sides and both of these sides. So if I have a 1.5 by 1.5 square, how far is it from the center to here and from the center to there? Because the story will be something like, I was telling my class the other day, say there's up for like $36, and she asked me, hey, what's 2% off or something? So I'll do the 10 in my head, move the decimal place over, make this 3.6, and then divide this by 10 in my head. So now your decimal place goes over here, and then multiply it by 2 or add it back together in my head. So then you've got 6 times 2 is 12, 6, 7, and I'll go 72 cents, eh? And she went, huh? Anymore, she's like, I don't even want to know, what is it? Now find the short way around if you're using just your hand. Right, I shouldn't say the short way, the easy way around. Oh, okay. So, we are 0.750 and 0.750. So if you notice, he did 1.5, because we want to make sure we're off our stop this way and our stop 2. Mm-hmm. So 1.5 is a little bit wrong. And then he did negative 1.75, which is over here. Because we only have to go over this way before we can go up and use the other side. So, usually what I do with my classes at this point is we don't care about this number anymore. We don't care about that number anymore, because the only thing I care about is this one, correct? And now we're over here. So we're at x of 1.75. And y of negative 1.5. gonna go over this way. This is probably where I have to switch. I'm not gonna draw directions on top of this. This is the next one. I'm going right next to it. So now we're gonna go this way. We're gonna go right up this line, and we're gonna turn it around. We're actually on top of it. And then we've got to turn it around like this. So if I'm going from this point to this point, what changes? X. So what's X going to be when I compare? X is what?
What's that?
What's my X going to be?
0.75?
Negative or positive?
Negative.
So what changes when I go up here?
Y.
My Y is going to be? You know what it is? You guess?
It's going to go more into the farther, so it's going to be 0.5 or greater.
Uh-oh. Remember, we split the part in half, about 0, 0 in the middle.
And then 0.75?
Yeah, positive. Yes, positive 750 and a negative 750 gives you that answer.
Yeah.
So now what changes when I go over here?
Your answer.
Yeah, so it's going to be, see why we put it in the middle? Now we're going to come down here, so now I'm going to have a Y of negative 0.750. And now I want to come off my part. So you can do the little trick that I like to do. But you don't have to. You can, as long as you come off your part, it don't matter. So in here, we're also going to have our D41. So now I could like to come off the part. I'll go back to the exact same point just to connect the dots. And I'm off the part. And I can use the same numbers because I don't want to work any harder than I have to. So if I know my X I started with is negative 1.5, you can make this X right here X. -1.75. You remember I used before, right?
Yeah.
And then you can come down here and make this Y, -1.75. And you'll have a G40 right here. Together. Just like you'll have a G41 together with this point. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Kind of sort of maybe. Step by step and make it simple. So now I need my G41. That's your 380. I don't even see my view. That's your forward. I always get 2 hours.
G55.
I got 55, but I need. If I spindle on, so that's going to be what M would be. And what we say S is going to be, we said that thousand.
That's right.
Now I got G43, H what?
2.
And then Z something over the part. Now I've got G01. Made up few ranges so we don't have to do the lights or the top of the part or something else we don't want to have to do. Negative something. So my negative is going to be what? That one's already.
174?
174. This plus the 50,000 for the top. So Z of -174. And then G01, G41, linear move, countertop on the diameter of my tool, because I didn't put that on the center line, you don't put it in at all. And then I need my X move to get to my next spot, which is what? Negative. Now it makes sense why I need that. I
I usually get to this slide and this slide better than I do that, because now it's good. At least it's worth my while.
And then my next one should be X, which is 7500. And my next one should be a Y, which is -7500. And then my next one's going to be an X. That should be the result back to where it started, so it's going to be a -1.75. And then the next line, I have to have my 240. Also have a X here. Where is that at? Remember? All the way out to the side. Same place it homes out, right? So you might want to leave this one out, but you want that one. And now we have a G90 and an M30. All the M30 does is says, hey, I'm going to go back to the top. That should run. Appreciate the very first time. But I wrote it with you. But you saw how I changed what he had. And I didn't even cheat. I could have looked at it before class, right? Because I wanted to figure it out with you guys. Show you the steps. And if I know all the answers ahead of time, it makes it too easy to do. It makes it seem like magic. It's not magic, it's numbers. You lost me confused?
It's bad.
That's perfectly normal the first time.